Hey everyone, it's Barış from Cuebric, and today I will be showing you how to do a concept design using Cuebric. Let's start by creating our project. After selecting the canvas size that works for you, you will see your empty canvas. The first tool that welcomes us is our image generator tool. On top here, we have 5 different image generation models and they all have their own cinematic look. Let's have a look at a model comparison pop-up from here. Down here, we have our prompt boxes. Here we need to write the things that we want to see in the generated image. And for the negative prompt, we need to write the things that we don't want to see in the image. Let's click on Generate Random Prompt button to get inspired. Remember that you can always use this prompt as a base prompt. Just change the main object and the other prompts to generate yours. You can structure your prompts in 3 parts to get great results. Let's break it down on that prompt for an example. The first part is where we describe our main object. On the second part here, we are describing our environment. Last but not least, for the third part, we can write our angle, light, and other prompts. To learn more about the advanced settings, you can visit our advanced prompt settings tutorial. Let's hit generate to get 4 different variations of our prompts. It is always helpful to mention that all of your generated images will be saved on your archive down there, so you can import them anytime with the prompts and settings or download them. Let's add our image into our layers by pressing Add to Layers button. If you want to generate at a different size, you can check the generation size box here to show the generation frame, which you can manipulate by dragging the edges. So let's generate. Then you can uncheck it anytime you want. Now, let's talk about inpainting. Once you click on the inpainting tool, you will see that we have 2 different modes. We should use fill to fill the transparent parts of our image. And the modify lets us change the existing pixels. To be able to change this modern house into a wooden shack, all we need to do is mask it. And then we can write our prompt as a wooden shack. We also have 4 different variations on inpainting. Don't forget to change your blending settings if you want your inpainted objects to blend more. Let's set our blending parameter higher and check out the results.
And I think it will be good to have some rocks here.
We got our perfectly blended rocks. So let's say you want to enlarge that image. Let's go to our Resize Canvas tool and let's drag the edges until we are satisfied. Let's go back to the inpainting tool and click on Fill. If you want to have more control over the generated image, you can write prompts, but you can even generate without one. Here we have our outpainting results made by using fill mode. Since our base generation size was 1280 by 720, we can go to Super Scale tool and upscale our image up to 10K. And you can select between 2 times, 4 times, or 8 times. If you don't want to resize your image, you can uncheck that box so super scaling will only enhance your generation quality. And here we have our super scaling result, so let's get a closer look to compare. And stay tuned for more tutorials from our team.